as I was saying, everyone in bluegrass has learned to pick the music from him because he's the man who started, he's the man who created the music, and no one played it before him. Once again, it's an honor to bring him on this stage. I'm sure you'll enjoy me still, one of the most dynamic performers in bluegrass music as well. So welcome once again from Nashville, Tennessee, and the Grand Ole Opry, the great Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys.
We're glad to be back here for the last show this evening of the Bluegrass Boys, and we're going to start right now. We're going to call on Wayne Lewis for a solo number, if you'll come over this way. And Wayne, what would you like to sing to the folks? I Will Never Shed Another Tear, a beautiful song.
Left me here forever, so I'll never shed another tear. I'll never shed another tear. Now I don't care what happens, for you have proved your love's untrue to me. There's nothing you can do that will ever change my feeling, so I'll never shed another tear. Heart, I'll never forget those vows we made together. For many times you told me not to fail, but now you've forgotten and you've left me here forever. So I'll never shed another tear. I'll never shed another tear. Now I don't care what happened. Oh, you have proved your love's untrue to me. There's nothing you can do that will ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear. And that I'd never learn to love you so, and that I wouldn't have all these heartaches, my darling, dreading the day I'd see you go. I'll never out here now. I don't care what happens. Oh, you act rude, you listen true to me. There's nothing you can do that will ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear.
Thank you very much. All right, Bob Black, get up close to the microphone now and turn it loose on the number called the Bluegrass Breakdown. To do a number for all the folks that come in today that wasn't here yesterday, the number of the Muleskinner Blues. Good morning. Kentucky Manly. It's going to be coming up just a little bit. Blue Moon of Kentucky. Only way I'll sing that is you'll sing with me on the chorus. Everybody sing it. Number, Kentucky Mandolin. Thank you. If one of you say over here, just round through the audience, would mention a number you say like. All right, that's enough right there. We'll do that right now. For you. Thank you. Number we get the most requests for, Uncle Penn. And we hope you enjoyed it. Now, just one at a time, please. Rawhide.
Rawhide.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I wish we did.
You know when the golden leaves begin. Keep them coming in so I can hear you now. Goodbye, old pal. Oh, now you're down beneath that man. Like the best pal I ever had. Oh, lay, yeah, yeah, yo, you lay. Baker to fiddle now. He's going to get ready and fiddle a number for you. All right, we're going to call on Kenny Baker, and here's one of his great numbers that he wrote himself. One of his albums is entitled after this number, The Grassy Fiddle Blues. Thank you very much. Bob Black is coming back to the microphone. And he's going to play a number that a lot of folks like today entitled The Foggy Mountain Breakdown. Thank you, Bob Black. That's fine picking there. That's Earl Scruggs number, and it's been a great number. Now, you know, there was a time when the Bluegrass Boys are at Nashville, Tennessee. We had three fellas from this country up here, one from Boston, I believe, and maybe a couple from Massachusetts. And let's see, we had Richard Green. He was from this part of the country someplace. But two of them's here today, and I believe with Nancy Talbert, it would be all right, you know, if they come out and sung a couple of songs with me and done some playing. Brad Keith and Pete Rowan, would you give them a hand, please? Now, you know, there was a time when Don Stover worked with me, too, on the Grand Ole Opry. He's there a pretty good while and done a wonderful job with a five-string banjo. Of course, he's already been on the stage, and I doubt if I can get him to come back. And the great Sonny Osborne, when he was 13 years old, 14, he worked with me and the Bluegrass Boys for a long time on the Grand Ole Opry when his brother Bob, you know, was in service. But he's going to be coming out a little later, and it wouldn't be right to ask him to come out now. I'd like to have him, of course. But all right, now we're going to move right along. And Brad Keith is a great five-string banjo player, and Pete Rowan is a good guitar man and singer. So, Brad, would you come over this way, please? What would you like to do for the folks on the banjo?
Well, I got a lot of favorites, and I think you wrote most of them.
What is one of them?
Well, one of them's Roanoke, and I sure enjoy playing that with you.
All right, we'll do that first. Pete Rowan, come over a minute, if you don't mind. Pete, we're glad to have you here. So Brad's going to pick one first.
All right.
And then you can sing.
Yes, sir.
Okay, take the guitar right. The first number that Brad will play is called Roanoke.
Thank you.
The man a hand. He was the first banjo picker to ever play that style, the kind of picking that he played on the Grand Ole Opry, and it was a big help to me and the Bluegrass Boys back when we needed some banjo picking like that. Brad Keith. All right, Pete Rowan, come over and do the folks a song, will you please?
Bill, thanks a lot. I'd like to do a song that originally was recorded by Mr. Ed Mayfield. I think he used to play this one with you. It's called Knocking on Your Door. Knocking on your door again, my darling. Well, I'm knocking on your door, please answer me. Well, I've tried to make you realize, my darling, that no one else was ever meant for me. And I remember, dear, you said you'd always love me, and you promised me your happiness so true. But now you're gone away, dear, with another. And I wonder if you feel the way I do. I'm knocking on your door again, my darling. I'm knocking on your door, please answer me. I've tried to make you realize, my darling, no one else was ever meant for me. My darling, I'm gonna return the letters that you wrote to me. I'll never read them now, my little darling. I'm going far across the deep blue sea. I'm knocking on your door again, my darling. I'm knocking on your door, please answer me. Well, I've tried to make you realize, my darling, honey, no one else was ever meant for me. Goodbye, farewell, adios, I know I'll forget you. And I hope that you find happiness so true. But wherever you may go, sweetheart, remember that my love will always be the same for you. I'm knocking on your door again, my darling. I'm knocking on your door, please answer me. But I'm trying to make you realize, my darling, can and won't you play that fiddle for me? Please answer me. to make you realize, my little darling, no one else was ever meant for me.
Thank you a lot, Pete Rowan. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I can't keep them no longer because they've got to come out just a little bit later on and do a show here this evening. All right. Molly and Tenbrooks is coming up now, and we hope you will enjoy it.
As you read this letter that I read,
understand. For you're the only love I know. Please forgive me if you can. That snow has covered up the ground. Your bed is hungry, sick and cold.
Sweetheart, I beg you to come home tonight. I'm so glad all alone. I promise I'll treat you right. Love will always come home. Sweetheart, I beg you to come home tonight. I'm so bad all along. I promise that I'll treat you right. Love will always come home.
Thank you. Thank you very much. When the Golden Leaves begin fall, we've had a lot of requests for that, but I've got some new boys with me today, and I don't think they know that number. If you would come up here and lead it for me, I could do it all right. Do you know it? Can you sing it? Do you know it? Me and you could do a duet with it. All I need is a lead singer on it. We have time for one more song, and we're going to do a number that's featured more on the Grand Ole Opry than any number. And before we do this number, I want to say it's a pleasure to be here with you today, and I hope that you've enjoyed the show. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you for buying the album. We appreciate that. Thank you for supporting bluegrass music and all the entertainers that play it today. They need the help. They want to play it for you, and today it's the most copied music in the world. And it's music that's really, really going to town. It's getting acquainted all over the country, over in Europe, Germany, all through the countries over there. And it's really great in Japan, and it's really growing. So we don't want to let it stop. Anytime when your country comes to us, we're glad to have you. And right now, speaking for all the bluegrass boys and myself, we want to say so long with this number here, John Henry, the Steel Driving Man. Colored boy, you'd hold him on the palm of your hand. And his papa cried out to the lonesome fellow. So I'm gonna be used to driving man, oh Lord. So I'm gonna be used to driving man.
Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys.
Thank you. You're the kind of audience that I like to play to and love, and I'm glad that you have given us a nice hand here today. I appreciate that a lot. The boys will come back. We will do another number for you. Thank you. All right, now, Kenny Baker. Kenny's going to give you this number here, and it's called the Orange Blossom Special.
That's the father of bluegrass music. Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys. Dick, I'd like to introduce I think we'll get them back to do one number in a second. We're gonna make a presentation first. They'll do one more. Yeah, they'll do one more. Hold on a second. I like first, you're welcome to the microphone, the person who has put it all together this weekend. She has worked 7 years promoting bluegrass music in the Boston area. She's worked about 6 or 7 months trying to put this festival together. They've had several different sites. They've had their share of problems, but she's put it all together somehow and kept it running all weekend long. And I think we all owe a lot to Miss Nancy Talbot, the co-promoter of the Berkshire Mountain Bluegrass Festival.
Thanks. David's going to make me cry. We've had several people coming today, over the last weekend actually, who have never seen a bluegrass festival before, who had never, really didn't know what bluegrass music was, and were asking questions about bluegrass, what it was, what it meant, and what in the world were all these people doing sitting out here in the rain. And I told them, I tried to tell them as much as I could what bluegrass music meant. I tried to explain that it's a passion, a love for a thing which is shared, I guess, by everybody here. And it was inspired by one guy in particular, a gentleman who had the vision and the discipline to stick with it for a long time. The word bluegrass is now getting to be known by people outside of just our particular group. And there's a man here tonight who has just added it to the Webster's Dictionary. He'll tell you about what he's done. Welcome, John Pollard.
Thank you very much, thank you very much. When I'm not trying to play the banjo off of Massachusetts, I spend my time writing Webster's Dictionary, or helping them write it. We came out with a book of 6,000 new words in the English language for about the past 20 years, and we decided it's about time that bluegrass got in the dictionary. Mr. Monroe, I'd like to present you with this copy of this book, this dictionary with bluegrass in it, and thank you for the many years of beautiful music, and the name to call it by is bluegrass. Thank you very much.
I thank you so much. Bluegrass, bluegrass, bluegrass. That's great. 1976, us here playing for you, and me receiving this book, and designing this music for all of you people. Oh, I love it. I love every one of you. Thank you so much.
Would you like to hear one more tune by Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys?
Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, now if I just can pick out a song for you, one that you will like. How about let us do Monroe's of Old Kentucky? Would you do that? That's easy, and it's got some fine banjo picking and good fiddling in it. Monroe's of Old Kentucky. She blues for me near a little village in a cabin on the hill. We made our vows, we love each other, and I know we always will. She's my rose of old Kentucky, I watch her bloom and it will burn. And to me there'll never be another. I'll ever tell the day I die. Oh, in dreams I see my darling, and I can't tell she looks so sweet. Oh, I long for old Kentucky, and my darling wants more to me. She's my rose of old Kentucky, I watch her bloom as the air opens. And to me there'll never be another, I'll ever tell the day I die. Oh, I know you often wonder, so I'll tell you the reason why. She's my rose of old Kentucky, and I know she will never learn. She's my rose of old Kentucky, I watch her bloom and it will burn. And to me there'll never be another, I'll never tell the day I die. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, that's the definition of bluegrass. I have strong hopes that Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys will be here next year, and that all of you will be here too. While we're doing sentimental things, this is a present. And it's for a guy who has had an awful lot to do, in fact, almost everything to do, with bluegrass in New England. Don Stover, who plays a five-string banjo, has been in the Boston area for 20-some years. He worked for a long time with the Lilly Brothers, of course, at the Hillbilly Ranch, and it was one of the reasons I came to Boston originally was because Don was there. He is now moved back to Maryland and has a farm down there. And we miss him a lot, and it's a little bit corny, but it's a present that we got for him, which I hope he'll come out and accept. Make Don Stover welcome. He's going to need a penknife to open it, I think.
Got me more nervous than as if I was at Carnegie Hall. Truly. Nancy, this is about the greatest honor that's ever been bestowed upon me.
Where do you see it?
I'm simply great. You mean I must open it here?
You better open it, yes.
Okay. Just for you. Who tied the ribbon there? Look, I'm truly, you got me all nervous now, Nancy, and all shook up. And
there's been so many a night when we had a show where I was nervous about something, and Don and I would talk to each other on the telephone, sometimes about ghosts, sometimes about flying saucers, about anything to keep our minds off whatever the current emergency was. Bluegrass, as everybody out there probably knows, has been a very delicately balanced thing for years up here in New England. We're far away from the roots, and all of us here are spread out some. We're not in close places. And to pull everybody together to make a show work is not an easy thing. It's one of the reasons why I think if you want to hear real bluegrass, it's always an effort to get to wherever a show is. It's an incredible amount of energy that goes into preserving bluegrass music away from, so far away from its roots. There are an enormous number of what I call real bluegrass people in New England, and I think we've got a lot of them here today, and I know that they owe affection and friendship to this guy who has had so much to do with keeping it vital in Boston. Have you got that thing open yet?
Yeah. I'll tell you what, Nancy, you've been so nice to all the folks up north there, and she's provided bluegrass music work for a lot of entertainers, and I swear that goes an awful long ways. And I think Nancy's doing an awful lot of credit, too, truly, for keeping bluegrass and old-time music alive in Boston. It's all yours, gal.
While we're about it, we ought to thank all of the Boston area Friends of Bluegrass and old-time country music people and David Webb. There's so many of you. A lot of people who've come up today have said, you know, who did this? Well, Dan Bump of the Beacon Banjo Company did this. The Boston area Friends of Bluegrass did it. The Connecticut Bluegrass Society did it. The Maine Bluegrass people did it. There are an enormous number of people who have pulled together to make this event the way it is. And I sort of think it's natural. I think it's the way it is. Would you open that darn thing?
It's been a real great festival. Can I say one more thing?
Yeah.
I think you could search the whole world over. And the finest entertainment in the bluegrass industry in the world is right here today, really, on this whole continent right here. Yeah. They had it here. And I believe it's going to be a greater and a bigger one next year. We're looking forward to it.
Can Are you I all going to come back next year?
Can I come back, too?
All right.
Can I come back, Nancy, next year?
Yeah, you can.
Here's the unveiling part.
All right.
Please hold that.
Wow. It gets fancier.
Looky here, boy. We're getting all fancy down here now. My goodness sakes, what do we got here? Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on this beautiful...
Let me read it to him.
Nancy, I am truly highly honored, really.
You want to know what it says? It says to Don Stover with love from a bunch of damn Yankees.
And it's an honor that's a great honor that I shall treasure for many, many years to come. Thank you very much, Nancy. Thank you, folks. Bless you.
Let's hear it for him.